Most problems in our world today are complex. Good versus evil is not as straightforward as I thought. But what's interesting is this particular issue, working on counter-child exploitation, is one of those few cases that actually is pretty clear-cut. It's pretty universally held that this is something we need to stop.
We are looking for a needle in a haystack. We're trying to find that child, or we're trying to help law enforcement identify an offender so that he or she cannot continue to re-victimize children. We don't have an army of staff. To be honest, we have to leverage technology to make our jobs better.
The work that we've done so far has helped in hundreds of cases, and I think that we can do more.
The content that they have to look at on a daily basis, it's as horrific as you can imagine, and then some.
The work we do here is really hard, but whatever I have to look at or see or view or hear that is difficult, all of that work is being done to help find a child, and so it makes it completely worth it.
NCMEC stands for the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children. Our role is to be the centralized reporting location for child sexual abuse material. We have a team of analysts that sift through tens of thousands of reports every week. Their goal is to try and locate those children.
As I'm coming across a report now and looking at it, I'm looking for clothing clues, things in the background. Is there a water bottle that I can figure out what brand it is? And this is what I'm using to try to figure out who is this person that has potentially traded or distributed this image and where are they located?
When you think about the sheer volume of information that's coming through, our biggest fear was that something was slipping through the cracks, that there was information being reported into our systems that we weren't identifying that could have helped to lead to that rescue of that child. And we knew that Palantir could deal with big data.
My name is Angela Mueller, and I lead our work at Palantir on counter-child exploitation. NCMEC receives over 60,000 cyber tip reports every single day. And so there's no way that they can look every single day at every single one of those reports. So the ultimate goal is to support NCMEC in surfacing the most actionable intelligence so they can get that to the hands of law enforcement who can make arrests as quickly as possible and rescue as many children as possible, oftentimes same day.
My name is Debbie Garner. I lead the Child Exploitation and Computer Crimes Unit here at the Georgia Bureau of Investigation. A few years ago, NCMEC sent us a cyber tip that included images that had never been seen before by NCMEC. When we receive information like that, we know that that is something that we need to act on immediately because a child could be in danger. We did some additional investigation, which led us to a location where we thought the child lived.
Something that's important to understand is that these images are rarely produced in isolation. They're produced as part of a set that often gets grouped together as a series, whether it's a single photo shoot or a combination of images taken at the same time or place. So NCMEC is able to group those together so that the analysis is richer. Analysts are very good at interpreting this information, but once the data scale grows beyond a certain size, they can't remember every report they've ever seen, or perhaps they've not seen all the reports. Through an algorithm, we can find that connection for them in an automatic way and suggest it to them, hey, maybe you consider these two reports side by side. We have reason to believe that they have something in common. Let's use technology, let's use data analysis to find those connections at scale, because a computer can scale to the millions, to the billions, even if a human doesn't have time to look at that many reports in a lifetime.
While we were there where we believed the child would be, we received additional information from NCMEC. They were able to provide us with GPS coordinates of where the content was produced. The coordinates matched our location. And at that point, we arrested the father.
We call law enforcement and we tell them that there's a hit based on a Palantir alert within our system. They drop everything and they work those cases. It used to take days to weeks when dealing with cyber tip line reports and seeing offenders arrested. Now with the Palantir alerts, we're talking hours from the time we've received the information to when law enforcement has made an arrest. As a result of one Palantir alert, there have been over 500 arrests and 350 children rescued.
One of Palantir's strongest features is that security was built from the beginning. It wasn't something that we realized needed to be a feature after we started building our software. And so that guides you in a certain way. Because this data is so sensitive, it's important that the software that we build is very respectful of the privacy and civil liberty limitations of the information that's in the systems. Doing the right thing for these kids is not just rescuing them, it's rescuing them the right way.
So technology is always evolving. And normally, the offenders are the first ones to adopt these new technologies. But the work that we've done with Palantir to improve our systems and processes has changed the game.
We need to build platforms that aren't wed to a certain way of fighting the crime. Data can be messy, data can change, and your software needs to be able to incorporate that if you're going to solve not just today's problems, but the problems of tomorrow and the problems of 20 years from now. Technology is not a means in and of itself, it's a means to an end. And the end is some real world outcome that is real, that is tangible, that isn't just lines of code. It's something that changes someone's life.
Hey, thanks for watching our video. We hope you enjoyed it. For more inspiring stories like this one, subscribe to Freethink.